This doesn't look right. There we go. What's going on, my dudes? Welcome back to J-Box Studios, your home for reviews, reactions, and, of course, ridiculousness. And yes, I am wearing my 90s getup because I am so excited to talk about this new Hulu series coming to Hulu this Friday, a revival, a reboot of something that I am very nostalgic for and I was a big fan of in the 90s. Animaniacs. 90s nostalgia is punching you right in the face with this rebooted animated series from the 1990s featuring a trio of wacky characters causing mayhem on the Warner Brothers studio lot. So is this rebooted Animaniacs absolutely blow me away? Take everything that you loved about the original and update it? Let's find out. But before I get into my thoughts, let me know what you thought of Animaniacs, if you've seen this new one, or if you were a big fan of the original, let me know what your favorite episode was in the comments down below. Now, let's get into some of the good. Oh my god, I am so excited to finally be able to talk about this because, a little backstory, I was a big fan of the original Animaniacs, watching it all the time. We had VHSs, I'm pretty sure still at my parents' place, we have VHSs with episodes. The candy store episode was one of my favorites. So that being said, I had a high bar expectations going into this rebooted series. Sure, we got the first teaser trailer or whatever with, you know, Jurassic Park with Animaniacs, and I was like, okay, that's a good start. And from the very get-go, this new rebooted season is everything you could ask for and then some. It takes that magic, that nostalgia, what you remember of the original, and enhances it, brings it up 20 years, and it is perfect. It's because the humor is self-aware, the characters are self-aware. They even play into the fact that it is a reboot, going 20 years later, playing into all of that. So I loved the self-aware humor, the commentary, everything that they're doing in this, where it pretty much is what the 90s version was, but again, brought into this time with technology, everything that has happened in the 20 years, and it not even missing a beat. The original voice cast, one of my big ones is Yakko, Rob Paulsen. I've listened to several podcasts with him. He is the one I was very much looking forward to. But all of the voice cast in this returns, from the three Warner brothers and sisters to Pinky and the Brain. Yes, Pinky and the Brain is back as well. And again, it feels and sounds and looks exactly like the 90s one, which is absolutely perfect. The humor, the musical numbers, everything, the self-aware sarcasm, the little tiny jokes that are hidden in the background, newscast with the scrolling bar. This is Animaniacs. They just took a 20-year break. But the thing is, with that 20-year break, there is a lot of material, a lot of references, a lot of jokes, even, like I said, self-aware things that they can play into with Warner Brothers, reboots, remakes, them being off for 20 years. Like, it makes for this delicious humor that is very nostalgic, very reminiscent, very funny indeed running through this. But they even go a step further where the animation feels like that 90s animation, but a lot more crisp. The edges are perfect, the backgrounds flow a little bit better, the characters, their fluidity essentially works even better. But here's the thing, and no spoilers here, but they play with animation styles several different times in this season, or this series. And God, I hope that they get renewed for like 5 more seasons, because I am on board for this. But going back to it, the animation styles. Imagine all of the different animation styles out there. Anime, a good example. They mess around and tool with and almost do a commentary on that kind of animation style by turning different pieces of episodes into that. And I will say that there is one scene that I wanted a whole season of these characters. So not only is all of that 90s magic of the Animaniacs there, but the rebooted kind of added material that they added in with the switch up of kind of animation styles here or there was absolutely nostalgic delight. However, I will say I have one little tiny tiny nitpick. And it's maybe because I don't remember exactly how the original 90s one played into politics and certain political figures and almost a commentary on that. I felt like this does maybe get a little too heavy-handed with some political references and some other material. I mean, they poke fun at the fact that they had to write this in 2018 and they didn't know what was going to happen, so they made up a lot of fun stuff. I think that maybe it's a little too much in a kind of a cartoon that you're supposed to, you know, just sit back and enjoy and nostalgia. But then again, I think it is reminiscent of the 90s, the original couple seasons or five seasons. Overall, Animaniacs, this reboot, remake, reimagining on Hulu is absolutely perfect. Everything I could ask for. With it literally doing everything that I wanted, with the same voice cast, the animation, the musical numbers, the jokes, the self-awareness, the sarcasm, everything that made the 90s one special, but updating it with some other material, especially some animation stylings, but with maybe a nitpick here or there about some political material, I cannot recommend Animaniacs higher. As a 90s kid, as someone who loved the original season or series and absolutely is nostalgic for this, I had a big old dumb smile on my face through all of the Animaniacs antics, and then Pinky and the Brain was just that cherry on top. I didn't even talk about that, but Pinky and the Brain is wonderful 90s nostalgia to the max. In closing, I'm going to give Hulu's Animaniacs 5 out of 5 90s nostalgia. So what did you all think of this rebooted Animaniacs now coming to Hulu? I want to know in the comments down below. And also let me know if you were a fan of the original, because my God, I absolutely adored this rebooted season or series, essentially. Anyways, though, as always, thank you so much for watching. Watch some more videos up there or right over there. You know, brand new content every single week here on the JBox Studios channel. I have no clue what's coming for the rest of the week, so stay tuned for all of my crap via the social media down below, because that's the easiest way. Like this video, subscribe to the JBox Studios channel, and until next time, we'll see you later.